the key thing with Socratic review method is to push yourself to be as clear with understanding the specific questions, the logic behind the logic behind it, and the intentions of the test makers. Because initially, when I look at questions, like I said, I would just look at explanations, and if the logic made sense to me, then it's fine. Then I think I understand and understood the question. But I wouldn't exactly look into each answer choice, even though the one I didn't select, and to ask myself, why exactly did I think this is wrong, and why exactly did I think this is right? But the Socratic review method, this sort of exchange with yourself, and to always push yourself to understand it as much as possible, helped me understand much better the intentions of the test makers. I started to notice traps in the answer choices more, and I started to notice what kind of wording, what kind of usually used tricks by the test makers could confuse me. And that allowed me to really adjust my habits to be more mindful of those traps. And I think that Socratic review method, also it can be done individually, but it might even work better when you work with a friend. It's kind of you translate that Socratic review method into sort of a seminar setting, and you ask each other, why exactly do you think this is wrong? And pushing yourself to really verbalize what you think also help clarify understanding.
Thanks for tuning into the show. Please subscribe if you haven't done so already to be notified of new episodes as I release them. And feel free to reach out if you need anything at all as you move forward with your prep. I'm happy to help however I can. In the meantime, I wish you all the best and take care.